Alright guys, got the belts all hooked back up, and I edited some of the things in the firmware to make it go faster, up the feed rate limit to 10,000. So when I home it, it looks like this. The bed moves very, very quickly. And it goes back and homes the Z, and ta-da, that's how quick it is now. Alright, so speaking on the tool changing specifically, the spring I am referring to is this one right here. When the tool change happens, this gear, this stepper motor has this gear reduction, obviously, for mechanical advantage, and it rotates this shaft, which rotates this barb, which on the back of this opening here, it's actually ramped, so it draws. It draws that shaft in, and that's that spring compresses on the back side, and that's what gives you your force that holds it onto this front plate. And so the problem I'm having now is it isn't sliding very well. There's a lot of friction, it seems. I've already checked if this is square from top to bottom, so I'm not binding on the bearings. It's sliding through. I've greased it up. You can see it's greased here on the gears. I've greased it a lot. You can see it, the grease is even just coming out of the ramp nut here on the backside. So I think what I'm going to do is I had some springs from work that were very close, but ultimately ended up being too loose and not stiff enough. And so I'm gonna go on McMaster and buy some new springs that have a little bit lesser of a spring force, so that I can maybe try to get this to work. If that doesn't work, I'm going to try to modify. There's these plates right here. One is quite a bit larger than the OD is quite a bit larger than the ID of the shaft, and one is kind of a slip fit. So I'm thinking about taking a little bit of sandpaper and trying to just barely file that down on the inside diameter and actually file it out so it just slides a little bit better maybe and doesn't bind, because I have kind of problems with that coming apart. I've already taken the shaft, put it in my drill, and taken a piece of sandpaper over it and tried to thin it down like that, but not much luck so far. So that's where I'm at with that. I can cheat and tool change it by pressing on this backside to compress that. Just not enough torque, and the spring just seems to be a little too stiff. So that's the plan for now, to change out the spring. Well guys, here's the first print. Let's go. Look at this thing. Going away at it. I'm so happy. There's been a lot of work to get to this point, and it's finally working. It's not perfect by any means, but I'm freaking printing, and I'm so happy about it. Just see the layers going down here. I'm printing with the mosquito liquid, as you can see, the liquid cooled hot end at with a 0.6 millimeter nozzle. I think my print speeds are 60 right now. I don't really know, to be honest. I think it's 45 actually. I just decided to take it nice and slow. But this thing is just printing so nice, and I'm so happy about it. I added this Stratasys fan to get some cooling on it. You can see we're probably about 90-95% done. I'm just running at 7 volts with 24 volt fan though, so I can really pump out some wind. And the latest change that I've done, which will be better in the future, this is just for the time being, is wired this fan up. So it's kind of jankily ran and connected to the board. But I have full control over this fan now for a park cooling fan. One thing I'm really wanting to do, and I originally planned on using these little blower motors, is this duct actually fits really well onto this tube, and use it as like a remote ducting system. So I'd have those blowers sitting somewhere in the back here on a electronics plate like this plywood you see there. Sorry, my dog's making a bunch of noise. And then it would travel much like the water tubes to the tool and then blow out the cooler jets of air onto the part. So I'll probably end up using the bigger blowers and reduce them down, which are over here. So here's the difference. You can see the two sizes. I'll probably end up using this one as compared to this one, just because I have more power there. All right, so test cube, it's washing out. Turn it down a little bit, there we go. Okay, so test cube, the bigger one that I'm running right now, I'm running at 150%, which requesting speed of 150, this is what it looks like. Moving pretty good, pretty happy with it. Can't complain much. Well, there we're getting a little printing artifact. I think we're going faster than our extruder can keep up with right now. Let me drop that back down to 100. There, now we're a little bit more manageable. Looks like I went out of its league a little bit there. Oh well. All right, here's the first benchy at 150% scale, that is. So let's see how it turns out.